It's no secret that NASCAR too has a lot of lost media that is yet to be uncovered. From what's been covered by NASCAR Man and Brock Beard in a Top 10 Lost Media Countdown video, to what's been cataloged on the Lost Media Wiki, you'll find out in this video that even this millennium gives us some NASCAR lost media. From a defunct sports network to a Busch North race on major network television, today we'll look at three instances of NASCAR lost media from 2001. Perhaps one of NASCAR's most forgotten television partners was with Ted Turner's 24-hour sports network, CNN-SI. As part of the new 2001 contract, CNN-SI exclusive coverage of NASCAR began in late April with the debut of the news program NASCAR Plus. NASCAR Plus served as the Turner sports answer to Fox's Totally NASCAR. The show itself was hosted by the network's own Johnny Phelps, with analysis by Benny Parsons, the 1973 Cup Series champion, and Marty Snyder. The show aired Mondays at 7 p.m. Eastern, with encores Monday at 9 p.m. and 11:30 p.m. Eastern, and Tuesdays at 12:30 a.m., 9 a.m., 12 p.m., 1:30 p.m., and 4:30 p.m. Eastern. In addition to the news, features, and in-depth analysis, Benny Parsons' mailbag was also a featured segment on the show. Parsons could send questions to Benny through the CNN-SI website and tune in to see if their question was answered. While no episodes of the series have been found online, a partial transcript of a Monday, July 2 episode exists courtesy of the Wayback Machine. The segment in question focused on the next race of the 2001 season, the Pepsi 400 at Daytona, and what was on the mind of several drivers, Steve Park, Rusty Wallace, Michael Waltrip, and Ken Schrader, as they returned to the venue where Dale Earnhardt Sr. tragically lost his life in the season-opening Daytona 500. Attempts to access the other segment links from the Monday episode result in dead pages due to not being archived. Staying on the subject of CNN Sports Illustrated, did you know they also carried live cup qualifying and happy hour? In the lead-up to the 2001 Pepsi 400 at Daytona, CNN-SI debuted their live NASCAR race weekend programming by covering Happy Hour, also known as Final Practice. Then Turner Sports president, now the chairman of NBC Universal Television and Streaming, Mark Lazarus, announced that the 16 qualifying and 8 Happy Hour sessions not covered on TNT would air on CNN-SI. According to MotorsportsTV.com, the live CNN-SI qualifying sessions received 5-minute updates at the top of the hour on TNT. While the majority of CNN-SI NASCAR Cup Series coverage is lost, the only footage to have resurfaced was this clip uploaded to YouTube on June 13, 2007, where Kevin Harvick as Matt Yoakum, or Power Ranger Matt, interviewed Kenny Wallace during qualifying for the 2001 Pop Secret Microwave Popcorn 400 from Rockingham.
Imposter.
Yeah. Kevin, they probably saw that stomach and said, whoops, he doesn't need any candy.
I think I need to shave and didn't put enough makeup on. That's the problem.
CNN-SI coverage of Cup qualifying and happy hour lasted through the 2001 Homestead-Miami race weekend. Despite the boost the network was receiving with its NASCAR coverage, including having added 40 cable systems by August 2001, the network was never profitable. On May 15, 2002, CNN-SI would cease operations. On many pay TV providers, the channel slot would be replaced with NBA TV, a network that would fall into the full control of Turner Sports on October 28, 2008. Any cup practice and qualifying during the NBC-TNT portion of the schedule not covered by the two networks would air on the Fox Sports Run Speed Channel through the remainder of the first centralized television contract. Benny Parsons' relationship with CNN would continue years later until his passing on January 16, 2007. Teaming with CNN's Michael Jones, the two would host a podcast over on iTunes called The CNN Racing Report with Benny Parsons. A link to these episodes can be found in the description of this video. Just scroll down to Around the Track. Shifting gears now, literally, the Watkins Glen race weekend of 2001 is best remembered for being the Gordon and Gordon show. Race winner Jeff Gordon was avenged of the race he should have won 1 year ago. Early contact brought on by Tony Stewart forced him out of contention, which brought us this infamous moment post-race.
In your mind what you want to do.
You know what?
If you're going to do it, then I'm going to do it.
Well, I'll slam you straight in the wall the next time you're anywhere near me.
First time you slam in the wall, you better get your
well, then what'd you do? What'd you just do? What'd you just do to me? I owe you one now, buddy.
Robbie Gordon, meanwhile, was in prime contention to win his first cup race. After allowing himself to lose Sonoma back in June when deciding to block Kevin Harvick, who was a lap down, instead of Tony Stewart, who was second, Robbie was strong throughout the race until being forced to retire on lap 58 when the NBC telemetry system caught fire inside his car. He'd have to wait until the season finale at New Hampshire to get his first win. What you probably didn't know was that the support race the day before was broadcast on network television. On August 1, 2001, it was announced that NBC would broadcast a Busch North support race, Little Trees 150, presented by Pepsi. The race would mark the first time since 1997 that free-to-air broadcast television covered a regional series race. ABC would broadcast the 1997 Winston West Auto Club 200 as part of the inaugural Auto Club Speedway Race Weekend, a support for the inaugural Cup event at the venue. Some of the notables to have competed in this event included race winner Tom Carey Jr. It was his first North Tour win since the 1999 Pennzoil VIP Discount Auto 100 from New Hampshire. Carey Jr. only made two starts in the North Tour's then true sister series, the National Touring Busch Series. His first was the 1999 First Union 200 in what was run as a Busch-Busch North combination race at Nazareth, finishing 40th after completing 88 laps due to crash damage. His other start was the 2001 Napa Auto Care 250 from Pikes Peak, his only standalone Busch race he took part of, where he finished last, retiring from engine problems. He's credited with completing only one lap. Finishing third was Paul Wolf. He currently serves as Joey Logano's crew chief. Their last two victories came at short track events, the inaugural Food City Dirt Race from Bristol last season, and the inaugural exhibition Busch Light Clash from the Los Angeles Memorial Coliseum this season. Wolf previously served as crew chief for then-Team Penske driver Brad Keselowski from 2011 to 2019. They together won the Cup Series Championship in 2012. Fifth place, Martin Truex Jr. He currently competes in the Cup Series for Joe Gibbs Racing, and the number 19 Toyota Camry. He has one Cup Series victory at the Glen coming at the 2017 race before finishing runner-up in the next two consecutive Glen races to Chase Elliott. His first North Tour win came at the 2000 ThatLook.com 100 from the New Hampshire Motor Speedway after starting from pole. In 2001, Truex Jr. would record two wins at Thompson and Stafford Springs, finishing 8th in the final points. Finishing 14th and carrying the race's title sponsor was Mike Olson. After 11 seasons, 2001 would finally not only see him visit Victory Lane at Beech Ridge and Epping, but also become a first-time champion in the North Tour. Drivers John Finger, Bobby Gearhart, and Tavo Hellman competed in the ARCA race at the Glen back in July. Tavo Hellman has one NASCAR win to his credit coming at the Laguna Seca Road Course in a 2001 NASCAR West Series race, but perhaps he's better known as the promoter that helped bring about Formula One's return to the United States with the 2012 United States Grand Prix at the then newly opened Circuit of the Americas in Austin, Texas. All nine of Bobby Gearhart's wins in ARCA have come at super speedways. Eight of those came at the season opening race at Daytona. The one that didn't was his second career win, which came at Talladega in 2001. John Finger won said ARCA race from Watkins Glen in 2001, and won the Rolex 24 at Daytona in the American GT class the previous year. I'll let him describe how interesting the ARCA finish was.
Well, the last race I was up here, 90, I won. I'm not going to jump on the roof because I can't afford it, but we're still looking for a little help. No, it feels great. This guy's worked good for me. My daughter's here helping me.
Tell me about those last couple of laps.
Just one of those racing deals. Somebody tagged me in the back. I was a little cautious. Spun, hit the wall. Coming back in, I noticed the black marks down there. It looked like a drag strip, but it kept running, so I took off. it's our first race. We obviously didn't know what we were doing, but we did all right.
Finally finishing 34th was Ted Christopher. Christopher is perhaps best known for being a veteran of NASCAR's Wheel and Modify Tour. He would go on to record 48 victories and would win the 2008 Modify Tour Championship. According to an NBC press release, the final rating for the Busch North race was a 1.6 rating and a 5 share. NBC was also due to cover the Busch North New Hampshire 125 on Saturday, September 15. However, following the 9/11 terrorist attacks on the United States, that race and the Featherlite Modified race from New Hampshire would be canceled. The New Hampshire 300 main event would be rescheduled for Friday, November 23, and would now serve as the 2001 Cup Series season finale. Thanks for watching this video.